Okay, now it is clearly audible to all of you. So today we are going to start the revision of those exercises which we have done in the last lectures, that is Indian literature, Antarctica, hares, and what else is there? Tips and beaches. So I think you all have prepared very well. So I'll be raising the question. You only have to raise your hand and I will give you the chance to speak. Okay, so the first question is, Antarctica is the dash largest continent in the world. You can raise your hands. Antarctica is the dash largest continent in the world. Yes, Kriti, you can answer. Kriti Gautam.
Ma'am, fifth.
Yes, the correct answer is Antarctica is the fifth largest continent in the world. And I have given you one video for this, that also you have to go through so that you will be able to understand. Okay, now next question is, the mainland of Antarctica continent was first discovered in dash. When was the mainland discovered? You can raise your hands. Navya, you can answer.
1820.
Yeah, that's correct. The mainland of Antarctica continent was first discovered in 1820. Good. Next question. It is the dash continent on the planet. What type of continent is it? Vaishnavi?
Coldest.
It is the coldest continent on this planet. There is hardly any vegetation. That is correct. Your answer is correct. Okay, next question is, the Antarctic Treaty was signed in dash. When was the Antarctic Treaty signed? You can raise your hands to answer. When was the Antarctic Treaty signed? Vansh Agrawal.
1959.
Yeah, that's true. It's 1959. Antarctic Treaty was signed in 1959. One more topic I discussed with you in the lecture when I sent you a video, that was, which is the permanent research station of this continent? Which is the permanent research station of this continent? I discussed about this also. Who will answer? The permanent research station in this continent. Anybody remember? I gave you one name. Any guesses? Which is the permanent research station? One I told you, that is the base camp for conducting scientific study, and one more I told you, that is the permanent research station. So what is that? Okay, I'll tell you the answer. So that the name of that research station is Bharti, that is the permanent research station for the continent Antarctica. Okay, now next question is, highest point on this place is dash. Which is the highest point on this place? Highest point, yes Nitya? Highest point on in Antarctica. Yeah, that is Vinson
Massive.
Yeah, that's true. It's Vinson Massive. Correct answer. After giving the answer, you can put your camera on mute so that there'll be no disturbance. Okay. Now, next question is, this continent has the dash air of all the continents. What type of air this continent has? Yes, Nehal?
Ma'am, driest.
Yes, this continent has driest air of all the continents. That is the correct answer. Okay, next question, little bit easy. So, the question is, dash is the most popular bird of this continent. Which is the popular bird? Vishal? Vishal, which is the popular bird of this station, this continent?
Penguin.
Yeah, that's true. It's penguin. Okay. The next question is, the first Indian expedition to Antarctica took place in the year. First Indian expedition to Antarctica took place in the year. Yes, Lavish.
Ma'am, 1982.
Yeah, that's true. It's January 1982 and it was, can you name that person who initiated this expedition? I told you. Have you remember the name of that person? Dr. Syed Zahoor Qasim. Okay. Now, one more question is, base camp established by India for conducting scientific studies is called. Bharti was the permanent research station and one more base camp was there. So who will answer for the base camp? You can raise your hands. Who wanted to try? Yeah, Sakshi, you can answer.
Ma'am, Dakshin Gangotri.
Yes, that's true. It's Dakshin Gangotri.
Ma'am, Dakshin Gangotri.
Yeah, that's a correct answer. It's Dakshin Gangotri. Now, one more interesting fact is that there is no port and harbors on Antarctica. Why? Because there is very less population, or you can say no, very few people are there. And so no need of any harbors and nothing. Only it has 19 airports. Just for the expedition and all they use. Okay. Now one more question. Live volcano on Antarctica. Which is the live volcano on Antarctica? Can you name the live volcano? Yes, Joy.
Ma'am, Mount Erebus.
Mount
Erebus.
Yeah, that's true. That is the correct answer. It's Mount Erebus. Okay, so now we'll come to the next topic, that is tips and beaches. That also we have done. I have explained you in the video. Those who have not understood can see that. Name the river that flows through Ladakh. I gave you a visit of Ladakh also. So name that river that flows through Ladakh. Who can name? Raise your hands. Which is the river that flows through Ladakh? Okay. I can see Natik. Yes, Natik. Yes, Natik, which river flows through Ladakh? I think some network problem is there. So, Shagun can answer. Yes, Shagun, you can answer. Shagun is also raising hand.
Ma'am, Jaskar.
Yeah, it's Jaskar River, which flows through Ladakh. That's correct. Next question. Name the place that is called the meeting point of Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean. Which is the meeting point of Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean? Tanvi? Yes, Tanvi?
Oh, Arabian Sea. Kanyakumari.
Yeah, that's the correct answer. It's Kanyakumari. Next question. Name the beach located on the Chennai coast. We have a drive on this coast also. So which is that beach? Okay. Which is located on the Chennai coast? Who will name? Yes, Dhruv. That's your turn. Dhruv?
Ma'am, Viga. Yes, ma'am.
No, Chennai. Chennai coast I wanted to know.
Ma'am, Chennai coast. Ma'am, Diga.
No, it's not Diga. I'm asking for Chennai. You are telling me for Kolkata.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, Chopati and...
No, that is...
Ma'am, Juhu.
No, that is Chopati. That Chopati and Juhu is in Mumbai. You again have to go. You have to visit. Still lacking. So, who is the other one who will answer? Name the beach located on the Chennai coast. For Chennai, you have to answer. Yes, Jay Adav.
Ma'am, Marina Beach.
Yeah, correct answer. It's Marina Beach. Next question goes to... I'll see who are raising the hands. Name few beaches along the Goa coast. You have to name the beaches which are along the Goa coast. Who will answer? I can see the screen. So, Ansh. Ansh, you can answer this.
Anjuna.
Okay.
Bagator.
Yes. Okay, maybe because it's very cloudy today, so some of you are not able to connect properly. Ritika is also trying since long, she's not able to connect. Yashashvi. Yashashvi Tomar. Yashashvi Tomar, unmute and on your screen. Put your camera on and unmute your screen. What are the beaches along the Goa coast? Yashashvi Tomar. You're not audible, neither you're visible. Okay, who else is there? Simran? Simran, you can answer.
Ma'am, Arena, Vagator, Kalangut and Baga.
Yeah, it's Anjuna Beach, okay, Vagator, Baga Beach and Kalangut. Yeah, correct answer. Now, next question is, name a charming beach resort near Kolkata. Name a charming beach resort near Kolkata. Which is the charming beach resort of Kolkata? Raise your hands. Nidhi Agrawal.
Ma'am, Diga.
Yeah, that's correct. It's Diga Beach. Correct answer. Next question is, now I have to ask about your hairs, something about your hairs, that is, why do some people have curly hairs and others have straight hair? Why is it so? Who will answer? Why do some people have curly hairs and others have straight hair? What is the reason behind that? Who will answer? Who wanted to give a try? Okay. Tanvi is there, Vishal. Who else is raising? Those who have not given any answer till now. One is okay. Tanvi, you can answer.
Round shaped follicles, the part of skin which grows a hair, make straight hair. Oval shaped follicles make curly hair.
Yeah, that's correct. The round shaped follicles, follicles means the part of the skin which grows hairs. If they are round, then the hairs will be straight, like the straight hair will come out. And if they're oval, means they are a little bit contracted. The shape is little bit oval, so the curly hairs will come out, and they are very minute. They are not so big. So depends on the size of the follicle. We have the curly hairs and the straight hair. Children, because so many screens are not visible, either due to some network problem. So maybe you are raising hand and I'm not able to see. So because it is very cloudy today, so don't take it on your heart. Ki ma'am has not asked from me. Whatever is visible, I'm just giving chance to them only. So doesn't matter. If those who are left unknowingly, then I'll be taking you in the other class. Okay. So don't feel bad about it. Now, next question is, why doesn't it hurt to have your hair cut? When you have your hair cut, why doesn't it hurt? Aapko nuksan nahi pahunchta hai. Whenever you go for a haircut. So what is the reason behind that? I can see very few screens. That is the same life problem. Okay. I can see Nehal. Yes, Nehal.
When our hair grows out of our skin, the hair dies. There is no nerve in hairs. That is why it did not hurt when we have a haircut.
Okay, that's correct. Like whenever your hair grows off your skin, your hair dies. That means now there is no nervous connection, no blood vein in your hair. So now it is a type of dead hair. So you will not feel hurt whenever it is cut. So it is okay. That is correct answer. So today we have covered the topics. Now one more topic is left. That is large and small countries. That is also left. Okay, I'll be raising the questions.